Έλα παιδιά, λοιπόν, this is a specially dedicated to some friends of mine. You know, everybody, we all have WhatsApp groups, no? And I have a group with lifetime friends who became brothers, and we call it the Knefe Dream Team. The Knefe is an Arabic postre, no? Knefe Dream Team. So this is dedicated to them. Of course, I cannot say their names because, you know, they work for YouPorn and Pornhub in the Middle East. They do the translation. Of course, they don't have a lot of words because everything is monosyllabic, you know. A-U, A-U, give it to me, and I gave it to you 10 minutes ago. Where were you, na pume? So this is dedicated to the Knefe Dream Team. You know who you are because I know who you are. And to my friend and brother Khaled over there in Jordan, in the Hashemite Kingdom, the beautiful Jordan. Dedicated to them. Operation QR in Palestine. Please take 8 minutes and watch this video, and I think you'll understand a little bit more what happens in this area of the world. For those of you who don't know, Dimitris Jimmis Tsapas, enjoy. Έλα παιδιά, good afternoon, Jimmis here, Jimmis Tsapas. I've been wanting to do this video for a very long time, but since it's a very sensitive subject, I had to think about it because I have lifetime friends on both sides that through life have become brothers, and I never want, you know, Jimmy's never wants to offend anybody, even though I could not do it. So the Palestinian-Israeli conflict, you know that it's the longest lasting conflict in the 20th century, and I think in the world, but in the 20th century. So I won't go into the history because it's automatically it's very sensitive. There's a lot of books and internet, you can read everything when it starts and everything when they come, the Aleya, the First World War, the correspondence Hussein Mike Mount, the Revolt 36-39, the Sykes-Picot Accord, the Rothschild Letter, all this bullshit, Napumi, that France and England betrayed everybody, they fucked it up completely. The Declaration Balfour, the War of Independence that they call, the Nakba, the War of 56, the War of 67, the War of 73, the oil crap. All this is in internet. However, there are some guys who are at the back of all this. And who are these guys? Malaga, these guys are the tortellini guys. You know, I call them tortellini because these guys, it's incredible. You know, it's like you take the Blues Brothers, you know, the Jake and Elwood, and you mix it with Bob Marley. You know, you have one here, Blues Brothers, Bob Marley, you put them together and it gives you this ultra-orthodox, ultra-orthodox that I call ultra-paradox, because these guys are always at the back of every burdello in that area. And the Israeli politicians know it, and they have been using them. Or I don't know, you take, the Reservoir Dogs from the Quentin Tarantino family, and you mix it with ZZ Top, and it gives you this. This is the change. So who are these guys? These guys, Napume, never existed. These guys never existed. These guys appeared like this, like Napume, a Marvel hero at the end of the 19th century, and they start dressing like this, Napume in black, you know, like the Blues Brothers. So these guys appear with a very radical idea of religion, and they start going over there, and they only speak Yiddish. So Israel, the Israelis, started speaking Israeli thanks to a guy called Ben Yehuda, who said, no, we are going back to the Israeli from the Bible and the Torah. Adaxi more, malaka, let's do it. No, so that we feel like a people. Ah, so you're not a people. Yeah, no, like this we will feel. Ah, okay. And then Ben Gurion comes, everybody starts talking Israeli. But these guys, the tortellini, keep talking Yiddish. So they are in Brooklyn, in Williamsboro, which is very funny because when you go to Williamsboro, it's like you go into the movie Matrix. You know, they are all exactly the same. All exactly the same. The only thing that changes is the hat. Some have this type of hat and some have this type of hat. But they're all the same. The women, they shave the head and they put a wig. Malaka, where is the logic, Ray? You shave your head to put a wig. No, because this is not to provoke man. Not to provoke man. Ray, Malaka, you fuck like rabbits. Well, now it's changed. You don't fuck like rabbits. You fuck like rabbis. And you have between 5 and 10 children each because you want to overpopulate over there, Israel and Palestine. This is what you've always done. And this is what you do in Williamsboro, Megale. Because thanks to your overpopulation, because you fuck like rabbits, you put pressure on the mayor of Brooklyn. Malaka, this is crazy. So these guys, you know what they do. You will have So, okay, blah, blah, blah. Accords of Camp David, two guys, Arafat and Yitzhak Rabin, try some sort, some way to find some sort of peace. One dies allegedly of cancer, but they never did the autopsy. And the other one, the Israeli, is killed, Yitzhak Rabin, assassinated by one of these radicals. Not with the tortellini, but the same. So what do these guys do? So, of course, you know, when they came and they cut all these pieces, you know, they start cutting Palestine in A, B, C, D areas, no? So what is A, B, C, D? Oh, no, 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 A is yours, completely yours. Yeah, Israelis to the Palestine, it's yours, it's yours. B is yours, but we control it. Why? Because we don't trust you. Okay, it's mine, you control it, yes, yes, yes. C is yours and we control absolutely everything, the roads, the checkpoints, everything. So it's mine, it's yours, but I control it because I don't trust you. So this becomes the QR operation and Palestine looks like a QR. So this brings you to the absolute paroxysm of madness that if a guy, you know, his house, if he has a big flat, he can be in one area in the living room and in another area in the bathroom. So if he's watching, for example, Ayman, he's watching Netflix in the living room and he wants to go to the bathroom, he has to pass three checkpoints. So from the bathroom, he goes, checkpoint one, Shlomo, where are you going? To the bathroom. Why? Because I need to go to the bathroom. I'm like, you have two more checkpoints. Shlomo, let me go to the bathroom. Ah, but then are you going to return? I'm going to return to the living room to see the end of the movie, Malaka. Shlomo, then we will do a check on you now, a prostate check, since you're going to the bathroom. And when you come back, we do another prostate check. So, you know, thank God Palestinians have a lot of sense of humor, because Ayman said, Malaka, in 10 minutes, if you don't shoot me, at least I know I'm not going to die of cancer, that I won't have prostate cancer. Like, this is the paroxysm of the QR operation in Palestine, so that you understand it now. So what do these guys do? You ask me, Malaka Mordechai Shlomo, what do you do in life? I study the Torah. What do you study the Torah? All your life? Yes, yes, I go to a yeshuva. Yeshuva? Yeshuva is like a madrasa for the Muslims. Yes, but we have the truth. You have the truth. Why, Malaka? Because we are the chosen people. Malaka, you chose yourself. It's like Greeks, we say we are the best ones. Tiles more Malaka. No, no, no. So what do? You don't work? No. Who pays you? The government. Ah, the government pays you. Do you pay taxes? No. Ah, you don't pay taxes. So you fuck like rabbits, well, like rabbis. You are paid to read the book, Napume, that only you understand. You don't pay taxes. And on top of that, you go sometimes to Palestinian land and you sit there. And you, obviously, Palestinians are upset. And they start throwing you stones. And then you start, ah, help. And then the idea, the Israeli Defense Forces go over there and protect you. Yes, this is our strategy. We learned it from the Japanese. What the Japanese? The Go. You know the system, the Go, the game Go, which is we make little black dots everywhere, and before they know it, we took over all over Palestine. Malaka, you're a genius, Epusti. You know what Palestine looks like right now, thanks to you? It looks like a QR. So in my opinion, your operation of the Haredis and the Hasidis is the operation QR, because you ate Palestine up, Malaka. And not all the Israelis want this, because something strange, you have the Haredis with R, as in R, as in Athens, for example, and then you have the Hasidis with Z, as in Athens, for example. So the Hasidis are pro a two-state solution, and the Haredis are pro destroy all the Palestinians. Malaka, agree on something, Napume. So what is their secret? The secret is, that's why Bibi Netanyahu, fucking Netanyahu, stayed there so many years, that these guys, since they fuck like rabbis, they vote. O sea, they don't pay taxes. They get money from the government. All they do is read the book that only they understand. Go and put burdello, you know, in the Palestinian land, arriving over there. They don't do anything. They don't even go to the army. When all the young little boys and girls go to the army and they're afraid, imagine they take you from your family, they put you in the army, Napume, from Friday to Monday. Only 10% of these guys go to the army because they're going to do it. Why don't you go to the army, Shlomo Mordechai? Because I read the Torah, Vrajde ke gamisu na pune, you read the Torah, you put the burdel over there in Palestine. So, you know, re pedia, you are not the ultra-Orthodox, because we are the Orthodox, the Greeks, the Russians, the Belarusians, the Serbians. What ultra-Orthodox? Malaga, From one side, you say,
no, women must not provoke men, and women have to be separate.
Which is what the Taliban say, no?
Women separate from men.
On the other side, on Shabbat, since you cannot use TV, electricity, and blah, 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 and you don't have Netflix, all you do is you fuck like rabbis. So, Malaka, you are an ultra-paradox. You are not an ultra-orthodox. Why do you take this cultural appropriation? We, the Greeks, are the orthodox. Not you, Malaka, that you fuck like rabbis. No, Megali. It doesn't go like this. So, since you have so many votes, which is paradoxical, ultra-paradox, you know, the right wing, since they want to stay the government, they give you anything you want. So, this is like a perpetuation of the problem. The more you fuck, the more babies, the more you vote, and you vote for the extreme right, so they give you the right, they give you the money, you don't work, you don't go to the army, you go in illegal settlements, but since you go over there and you vote for the extreme right, they continue giving you the same. Megale, this is never going to stop. So one day, Israel is going to have a serious problem, not the Palestinians, Israel. Israel is going to have to choose between a democracy and theocracy. The Palestinians already have their problem, and thank God they have you, because if they didn't have you, the Palestinians would have a problem between Palestinians. And it's not just the, you know, the Al-Fatah and Hamas. No, 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 it's the Christians with the Muslims, and within that branch you have those who think left, those who think right. It's the branch of the branch of the branch of the branch of the branch. And the same happens with Israelis. You have the right, you have the left, within the right and the left, you have the branch of the branch of the branch of the branch. So you have two huge trees with 1,000 branches, a completely opposite, ultra paradox, and at the end of the day, both of you completely forgot what the tree was supposed to give. So they go over there, illegal settlement.
Oh, we're here, we're being attacked by the very bad Palestinians.
Zare Malaka, you're in their land. You know what they do? Unfortunately, when the Likud was there, which is extreme, they were paying these guys to go there. And they were changing them every other week or whatever, 6 weeks, because they were stressed out. Go and do the settlement. If they attack you, we will send the army to protect you. And after a few months, we will build 3,000 apartments. Not 3 or 10, 3,000! And once we keep it there, the Palestinians will complain. But after 10, 15 years, we're going to say,
we are going to annex this, because look, most of us here are all Israelis, so we have to annex it.
Remalaka, this started because the tortellini came here, Napume. And this is how they start eating up. So when you go to Palestine or Israel, it's very funny, because all the top of the mountains, the hills, not the mountains, the hills, it's all these illegal settlements looking down. This is like the Game of Thrones. But the strategy they have been following for a very long time, especially when the extreme right was there, is the go strategy, and the operation is Operation QR. Why? Because now Palestine looks like this. So, in the future, if and when one day they reach an agreement, how am I like a genius, Napume Shlomo Mordechai, you are going to do this? You know what you have to do? You're going to have to say, okay, we fucked up. But the Israelis never fuck up, because they never confirm or deny. So, Malaka, you are going to have to give back all these thousands and thousands of apartments and turn this QR into a yin and yang, if you ever want to live in peace, as you say. But I said, not all Israelis and not all Palestinians are either good or bad. It's just a political thing. It's the political use of religion and the religious use of politics. And I hope that before I close my eyes forever, I will see the solution. Yeah, Dimitris Jimis Tsapas, and for my brothers over there in Palestine and Israel, the Muslims, the Christians, the Jews, I hope I've never offended anyone. I try to do it with my humor. But if I have offended any radical, I have a line. It's a hotline, 1-800-KISS-MY-ASS. Or, for very good clients, extremely fanatics, you can always send an email at info@ringmybell.org. The pedia, Dimitris, the Greek genius. Think about it. The go strategy to achieve the QR operation. Think about it.